At the outset of a green glass project, SCS cleanses, normalizes, and matches your library's bib records to WorldCat. We also filter out records that do not meet specific technical requirements or project parameters. In the upper left corner of the collection overview, you will see the number of bib and item records delivered to SCS from your library. The number of filtered records appears in the second row. The filtered records remain in the analysis because they meet all of the SCS requirements and project criteria. The records that have been filtered out of the analysis are available to you via this link or this tab. Note that the first three remediation lists represent items that have been filtered out of the analysis. There is no overlap between these three lists. Out-of-scope records have reliable OCLC record numbers, but for a variety of reasons, they do not match the parameters of the project. Records for all out-of-scope items are found in this list. To learn why these items have been deemed out-of-scope, retrieve them by clicking on the hyperlinked tally, and then export the list by clicking here. All of the standard green glass record details are delivered in this list, plus a couple of extras. The reason for an item to be deemed out of scope will always be found in one of 8 columns. Those columns are spread throughout the report and, for purposes of this demo, are highlighted in yellow. Keep in mind that there may be one or more than one reason for an item to be filtered out. The first reason is that there may be specific location codes that your library has asked to have excluded from the analysis. For example, special collections, reference, or juvenile literature may be out of scope for some projects. Location codes are found in column A. Use Excel's filtering dropdown to learn which locations are represented in the list. If all of the location codes that appear here are in scope for the project, you'll have to look further. Some projects are scoped to include specific languages. The primary language code can be found in column L. It comes from the MARC 008, bytes 35 through 37. The bib record type code is found in column M. It comes from the MARC leader, byte 6. Here are standard MARC type codes. Review the codes in your list to determine whether some items were filtered out of the analysis based on record type. The bib level is found in column N. This code comes from the MARC leader, byte 7. Green glass projects are focused on monographs, so bib levels A and M are typically in scope while others are out. If a record contains either a GPO item number in field 074, subfield A, or a classification number assigned by a government agency, field 086, subfield A, the resource is assumed to be a government document. If your library's record contained either of these data elements, they will appear in columns O and P. Government documents often fall outside the scope of a particular project. SCS may also use your library's item type and status codes to filter out specific categories of material, including those that are lost, missing, non-circulating, or non-book resources. Your library's item type and status codes are delivered in columns BA and BB, respectively. Despite the fact that these resources have been filtered out of green glass, you still have the opportunity to evaluate them with regard to subject, location, WorldCat holdings levels, local transactions, and HathiTrust status. If you have trouble interpreting your list of out-of-scope items, or if project filters should be adjusted in any way, please don't hesitate to contact your SCS analyst.